Guten Tag! Welcome to the Composer Detective, where we investigate the lives of the world's great and influential composers. I am your host, George Frideric Handel. I am the German Baroque composer who is known for water music, operas, and oratorios like the Messiah. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! I am Handel, George Frideric Handel. Remember, the Baroque era was such a great time of grand, fancy, and almost decorated sounding music, with almost a frivolous use of frills, trills, and extra notes. But now, let's look at the musical era that came after the Baroque period. It is the Classical era. The Classical era is known for being structured and orderly, without all the frills, trills, and extra notes. How fun is that? I would like you to meet a composer from the Classical period. Welcome, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
Guten Tag, Kinder. I am Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. Can you say my name? Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
I am the greatest composer who ever lived.
Wait, someone told me that I was considered to be the greatest composer. I am Johann Sebastian Bach, the famous organist and choir master, and a prolific German Baroque composer from a family of musicians. I am known for the Brandenburg concertos, and for cantatas and oratorios, and for toccatas and fugues and inventions.
Maybe you were the greatest composer before I came along. Besides, you are a composer of the Baroque period, while I am a composer of the Classical period.
So maybe we could say that I am the greatest composer of the Baroque period, and you are the greatest composer of the Classical period. Well, it does not matter to me whether I am great, for I want God to have the glory.
That's interesting. I don't quite think that way, because I've always had such glory for myself. You see, I was a child prodigy. That means I was a fantastic musician, even as a child. When I was 3, I started to learn to play the violin and the piano, and I wrote, "Twinkle, twinkle, little star." I could replay melodies after hearing them one time. Both my parents were musicians, and my father, Leopold, nurtured my musical talent. I was composing piano concertos at age 4, and I composed my first opera at age 11. Have any of you children composed a piano concerto or opera yet? Few do. My sister, Maria Anna, whom we called Nana, was also a gifted musician, so my father planned concert tours for us all over Europe. We traveled and performed in Germany, France, England, and Italy, and also Austria, of course, where I was born. Audiences went wild over us, but unfortunately, we usually received gifts for our performances rather than money, so I've always struggled with money. But I was able to study the music of Georg Friedrich Handel and learned counterpoint in German.
Yeah, even in your genius as a composer, you took time to study us Baroque composers.
Yeah, I enjoyed hearing your music when I visited London, and I even reworked some of Bach's and your pieces. Well, children, you may be cute now, But as you grow older, not everyone will think you are so cute, and you will have to get a real job. That is what happened to me. I got a job as a court musician for the Archbishop of Salzburg, but he was rude and wanted me to write boring pieces at the last minute. Not that writing the music was a challenge for me. I could hear the music in my head and write pieces out quickly. But the job did not work out very well, because my father had always taken care of everything for me, so I did not learn responsibility as a child, and I continued to struggle to act like an adult. I want to spend my money on parties and wigs and clothes and billiards. Anyway, my job with the Archbishop did not work out very well because I wanted to make my own decisions and write music I wanted to write. So I moved to Vienna, a city of music, and I met Joseph Haydn, the father of the symphony. Papa Haydn and I struck up a friendship, and why not? He recognized my talent, even telling my father, "I tell you before God and as an honest man that your son is the greatest composer that ever lived. See?" Also in Vienna, I got married and I wrote lots of operas, concertos, symphonies, string quartets, requiems, masses, piano sonatas, yada, yada, yada. Maybe you have heard of my operas? The Magic Flute? Or The Marriage of Figaro? Or Don Giovanni? Or perhaps you have heard one of my symphonies. I have over 50. Surely somewhere you have heard some of my music. Now let's review about me. Repeat after me. Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
1756 to 1791.
1756 to 1791.
Child prodigy.
Child prodigy.
Composed and performed around Europe at a young age.
Composed and performed around Europe at a young age.
Prolific classical era composer.
Prolific classical era composer.
The greatest composer who ever lived.
The greatest composer who ever lived.
Auf Wiedersehen!
So, that is Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. He was known for his quirky personality, perhaps immaturity, and because he struggled with money, he worked day and night. Eventually, his health suffered, and he died at the young age of 35. He accomplished a lot for the musical world in those 35 years, and is the quintessential classical composer with the structure and refinement of his pieces. Some say it helps you to listen to Mozart while you study, perhaps because of the structure. Thank you for watching The Composer Detective today. Please join me next time when we will learn about other great composers like Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart and me. Ephesians 5 says, "Sing and make music from your heart to the Lord, always giving thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ." Perhaps you like to sing or write music. Do it for the glory of God. Perhaps you will be the next great singer or composer, like Handel, Bach, or Mozart. Please like this video and subscribe to our channel. Auf Wiedersehen from George Frideric Handel and The Composer Detective.